Hi guys, I'm David with Media Unlocked, and today I'm going to be talking about a fig rig, homemade fig rig that I made. Now, if you don't know what a fig rig is, it's pretty much a steering wheel-like design where your camera goes in the center of it, and it's used to steady your shot. Instead of doing a handheld shot, you're actually going to steady it with this. Now, one of these normally costs you about $300 if you go online and buy it. Well, Indie Mogul, another YouTube channel I came across, showed me how to make one for like 40 bucks. So first off, there's going to be a link to their video on how to make this down below in my description section. So if you want to go make one of these, then $42 is what I spent to build this bad boy. You can do that, or if you want to wait a couple weeks, I'm going to be putting out my own tutorial that's going to be a little more descriptive at how to properly put this thing together. So this is it right here. And what you do is you take this. Now you could go, I do plan on buying what's called a quick release. I'm going to set up a quick release on this so I can take this on and off a lot easier. So what you can do is we're just going to screw on my T3i here. And this is probably the biggest pain in the butt right here. So I got my 18 to 55 on there. And you're going to screw it all the way on. And it's really a pain in the butt. And then what you do is to secure it, you got this butterfly bolt, and it just screws all the way up to the top. And now the camera's pretty secure, and you have nice fluent motions when you're shooting. Now, some of the things I don't like about this design is, one, you don't have to, but what I did is I spray painted this whole thing. And then I left it in my car. It was like 9 degrees yesterday, and the spray paint was actually melting off of it in certain, like down here in certain places, which is kind of funny. So you probably want to get some decent spray paint, better than the spray paint I bought for it. So the other thing I don't like is you cannot put a shotgun mic on this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to figure out how to design a piece here. I'm going to set up the shotgun mic right here on the top. It'll just set here instead of right here on this hot shoe. So I haven't figured out how to do that yet, but I'm going to try to design something for that. Then I got these lawnmower grips on the side. They're able to keep my hands nice and comfortable while I'm shooting. And this is a pretty light piece. So some exciting news is that I have a few videos on YouTube that are partnered up. Not myself in general, but a few of my videos are revenue sharing. And I made it right at $100. So what this means is, since I made my first 100, it took like 2 years, year and a half to 2 years to get that $100. Google should be sending me money here within like the next month or two. And with that money, instead of keeping it for myself, I'm going to invest it in two or three of these bad boys, and then I'm going to give them away to you guys. So stay tuned. That should be hopefully happening within the next month and a half, as soon as I get my money sent to me from Google. And I'll be giving a couple of these away to a couple lucky YouTubers that could use this to help with their film projects. So again, this is the Fig Rig. $42 to build. You don't need a lot of stuff to do. It's real simple. You can go to Lowe's and get everything you need. That's where I bought it at. And I'm going to leave you guys with some footage at the end of handheld versus the Fig Rig. You'll be able to see the difference in quality as far as the smoothness and the panning. Anyways, check us out on Twitter, YouTube. Click that yellow button up there. You guys have a wonderful day.
So I now have the Canon T2i hooked up to the Fig Rig, and as you can see, I'm just going to walk around this general area, and you're going to see how much steadier this is going to be. And then I'll do the same thing, and we'll walk around with it handheld as well. The only thing I don't like about it is, and something I'm going to have to figure out, is I'm going to have to build a mount for my audio up on the top. So that would be a bit difficult, because you cannot put my mic on this quite yet. There isn't enough clearance on it. But this is me kind of walking in a circle. And I'm just going to do a pan now. And a slower pan. Now, one thing I did notice is you kind of want to do things a little bit slower with the Fig Rig. If you go at normal pace, you're going to notice that it's going to be a little too quick and people's eyes aren't going to be able to catch everything. So as you noticed when I was walking around the circle, it might have been a little bit difficult to see what I was doing, but right now I'm just panning really slowly, and you're just not going to get that smooth look when you handheld it. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this off the Fig Rig and I'm going to handheld it. This is the same picture. This is being handheld. The way I'm doing it is I'm gripping the camera from the right side and I'm holding the camera from the bottom. So my left hand is underneath the camera. My right hand is holding it up from the right side. And I'm pretty much going to just do the same thing, and you're going to notice how much smoother the Steadicam was that I made. So now we're just going to do some pannings like we did before. Now if you're standing still, the panning may not be as bad, but you're still probably going to notice that looked a lot better on the Steadicam.